Good evening, Munir Ajam. I'm recording, probably this is the last video from Turkmenistan before I head back to Dubai. Another topic on project estimating. Yesterday we did a couple of topics, one on what the component for project estimate, and then the second topic was how to prepare a good estimate. Today I'm going to talk about how many estimates. The question is, how many estimate should we have along a project life cycle? Now, of course, we are assuming here, we have to start with the concept that the project life cycle is end to end, from idea to project closure. We can also say ideally from a project owner perspective. So how many estimates should we have? Of course, some of those who think the PMBOK process group or ISO process group are project phases, they would think that is, we do one estimate, because estimating is part of the planning process group, and the planning process group happen once, which is in their view if it's a phase. However, remember, the process groups should repeat in every phase of a project. So technically, in every phase, there could be an estimate for the phase or the stage. Beside that, so basically what we're saying here, if you have five phases on a project, you probably have five estimates. If you have six phases on the project, you have six estimates. If you have three phases, you have three estimates for each phase. However, the question that I've been posing is that how many project estimates should we have across the life cycle? So basically an estimate that deals with the whole project cost, not a single phase. Since the process group in this case is not the answer, then ideally there could be many estimates, but most capital project maybe, or other type of project, will have at least 2 to 3 estimates across the project life cycle. The first estimate typically happen during the feasibility stage, or in the CAMP model is what we call the discovery phase. We will have the first estimate, and usually that's what we call order magnitude estimate, which would be very high level, not detailed, probably depending on techniques like analogous estimating technique or factoring estimate, using history based on previous project. And these estimates obviously will not be detailed, will not be accurate enough for control, will not have enough detail for control, and will not be useful for funding the project. It will be too risky. But these estimates are still good enough, even with the range that could be minus 50 to plus 50 or minus 50 to plus 100%, to consider them in the commercial analysis for the project, the financial modeling and the financial evaluation, and make a decision whether this project makes economic sense and should continue or not. So that is the first estimate, and usually is done in, and of course the estimate we're talking about here, cost, but it's cost and schedule. And these information are used in the feasibility study as part of the evaluation, and they are considered in the decision on the project. Beside that, after the feasibility study, usually there is some work done on the project, defining requirement, maybe project management planning, and some other consideration. And with that, we will have more information about the project. We will have more information about the project, and which will allow us to do another estimate that probably more, not probably, for sure, more detailed than the previous one. And but still not detailed enough to allow funding if we want to minimize risk on a project. And usually these estimates are based on the what you call the requirement and the project management plan. And they could have an accuracy level of, or a range of, somewhere between minus 25 to 50% on a given project. So with that in mind, these estimates would be good to help us make a decision whether the project should continue or not. And management would be able to depend on that estimate for that purpose. Now, to estimate this type of project, this second type of estimate, we usually depend on a mixture of parametric estimating and maybe still analogous estimating in some areas as techniques, maybe some factoring estimate, which would be good enough. Now, after this estimate, usually the organization will proceed into what Sukkot Camp model calls the project definition stage, or in capital project might be considered the preliminary engineering phase or stage, or could be called FEED in oil and gas or chemical plants. They usually call them FEED, front-end engineering design, or front-end engineering packages, FEEP. And this estimate will include quite a bit of detail. Obviously not enough engineering detail, but it's significant detail to allow us to generate an estimate that could be minus to plus 5% or 10%. And that's good enough estimate to allow the organization management to take risk, because that's a narrow range. And they will be able to probably, of course, if the project still make economic sense, to approve the project to proceed into execution. And usually after this estimate, this would be used with the final financial approval, where the organization will officially, formally fund the project and authorize the team to proceed into what we call the implementation stage, capital project or real estate project or industrial project. It could be the engineering and construction, or engineering procurement or construction, or design build, or engineering procurement, installation and commissioning, whatever term you typically, your organization uses, that will be after this estimate. And of course, after approval. Also, this estimate will be used to and converted into control accounts and time phase budget and performance management baseline to use it for control purposes during the implementation stage. So, in summary, we have a phase or a stage estimate in every stage, but we have one estimate at the feasibility for the project. We have an estimate two during development phase of a project that could help continue to decide to continue with the project or not. And then we have the final approval estimate that would be used for the final decision and funding. And of course, after funding, if the project is approved, we'll proceed to, we can also convert it to a control estimate. So three estimates. In some situations, some organization, if they split engineering from construction, they might do an estimate after engineering as well. With this, we say thank you for listening. It's time to go and record an Arabic version of this video. Thank you.